ist der Dr. Müller. Was kann ich für Sie tun?
Hallo, guten Tag. Ich bin der Herr Murphy und ich möchte gerne einen Termin vereinbaren.
Ja, sehr gerne. Was haben Sie denn?
Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is Chris checking in with another video. I hope you are off to an excellent start to your day. And if this is your first time watching a video on my channel, my name is Chris. I come from the US. I am currently living in Munich, Germany, but I am preparing to transition to the United States, where I will pursue a second master's. I will reveal that in a later video, but on this channel, in the meantime, I like to talk about everything China, Germany, the United States. I speak 6 languages, I'm a polyglot, and I make motivational videos. So if you think any of these videos are interesting, please consider hitting the subscribe button and activating the notification button so that you know when I upload videos, which is usually every week, and join the community. So guys, I have a pet peeve, and it's German bureaucracy. And I'm always hit in the face with German bureaucracy and even German hierarchy when I visit the doctor. One thing that I have not gotten used to yet is when I call on the phone, I say, hello, my name is Chris. I'd like to have a meeting or with a doctor. And the response will be, yeah, what's wrong with you? What do you have? In the United States, it may be different from other people, but where I grew up in Michigan, the secretary doesn't have the authority to ask you personally why you need to see the doctor. You can just make an appointment with the doctor, especially if you've been there already. You can just say, I want to see the doctor. But here in Germany, they'll say, was haben Sie denn? So basically you have to say, oh, well, you know, I have diarrhea. Oh, I have a headache. Oh, I have something even more personal and private, right? And it is expected, from my understanding, that you communicate this information to a person who is not necessarily qualified to address the information. And sometimes I think it's really interesting because people really care about Datenschutz in Germany, but it's like in this interaction, you're revealing information about your health condition to someone who is not going to be your doctor. And so sometimes I'm like, I don't want to tell you what I have. I just want an appointment and I will tell the doctor what I have. Because ultimately, like, maybe I'm not comfortable with telling you, but I always, you know, tell the person regardless because I don't want to make a scene. But anyway, it's a culture shock that I've noticed. I don't know if any other Americans or any other foreigners living here have ever experienced that when you try to make an appointment with a doctor and they ask the person who is not the doctor when you call, it's like, what's wrong with you? What do you have? Do you find that weird? Do you find that awkward? Let me know in the comment section below. So you guys know that I used to work with kids. I used to work in a kindergarten as a French teacher. Now working with kids, you gotta get up, get down, run around and everything. So I've actually been having some back problems. I used to get sick all the time. I used to have stomach aches. I used to have back pain because I would have basically wrestled with the kids. I'd be on the ground with the kids basically. And so the chiropractor knows me and then my house aunts know me. It was to a point where I could not stand up. I literally felt like my back was broken. I went to my house aunt's basically in pain and she said, okay, come. And so I came, I had to wait an hour and she said, oh, we can't help you. So she sent me to the ER. Okay. I went to the ER. Oh, we can't help you. She sent me to another doctor in the other side of the city. Oh, we can't help you. You actually have to schedule an appointment with the orthopedie, right? I can't remember the English translation, but I will write it in below. And so in this time, I spent literally 6 hours going back and forth between doctors and waiting rooms, right? Just to be told that I need to go sign up. I need to find an appointment with a orthopedie, basically, which I would have to wait another week for. And mind you, I can't stand up. I'm in excruciating pain. Yes. The only thing they can give me was ibuprofen. So I took ibuprofen to reduce the pain, and then I had to wait to see the doctor. When I got to the orthopedie, guys, he said, oh, actually, there's nothing wrong with you. Let's send you to a radiologist to get testing to see what's wrong with you. I'm like, hold on. I literally just went to three doctors, the emergency room. I was told to come here. I waited a week to see you, and now you're telling me in 2 seconds that after I get here that I have to go and see the radiologist to get testing. Why couldn't the house arts just send me to the radiologist to get testing? So basically, I went to the radiologist and got testing, and I had to wait another week, and I was prescribed more ibuprofen to calm myself, to calm the pain. And I had a CAT scan, all included by German's health insurance, which is wonderful. Took the testing back, and basically he said, oh, actually there's a an issue with your disc, basically. You know, it's a nerve or something, it's being pinched because you've been, your posture is bad, you need to, you know, have better posture. So we're gonna schedule you up with 6 appointments to see a physiotherapist. And it took a month, guys, it took a whole month for me at the beginning in excruciating pain, to see the doctor, to see if I went through 4 doctors. Like, the hierarchy is insane sometimes in Germany when it comes to seeing a doctor. And so basically I am doing fine. I went to go see a physiotherapist, all included by the health insurance. I only had to pay about 24 euros for the massages that I had, which is like, not bad at all considering how expensive healthcare is in other parts of the world. But still, I couldn't help but wonder, goodness, if it's not an emergency, it's really, really difficult for you to get the help that you need through the bureaucratic system. So later on, I had another issue. So I visited a dermatologist because I actually had surgery a year ago, and I made a video about that, what it's like to have surgery in Germany. And so in Germany, usually when you need to see a doctor, you have to, the specialist, you have to go to your house arts first, and your house arts makes a referral to that specialist, basically, and then you can go. So basically you have to make 2 appointments. One, to tell the first doctor that you're, that something is wrong with you, and then you go home and call the second doctor, make an appointment with them, and then you go to the second doctor. But I said, you know what? I've actually already have been to this dermatologist. I'm just gonna make an appointment with the dermatologist for my, for, you know, whatever problem that I have. And I called the dermatologist and I made an appointment, and they're like, what's wrong? What do you have? I told them what was wrong, basically, like, you know, what I had. And when I got there, he was visibly upset, the doctor. He's like, what's wrong? What do you have? And I'm like, oh, well, I have this and this problem. And he's like, okay, check me out. He's like, normally people make appointments with house arts first. You don't have to come to me to solve this issue. And I'm like, yeah, but you're my dermatologist, right? You're my dermatologist. I guess in my mind, from where I come from in the United States, if I have a dermatologist, for even if I have a family doctor, that's what a house arts is called, a family doctor, if I have an issue related to skin, I won't go see my family doctor. I'll go to my dermatologist. If I have an issue with whatever, like there's a specific doctor that I go to, I don't have to go through this hierarchical process. And the fact that I didn't do that actually made my doctor upset, visibly upset. And he kind of scolded me by saying, go to your house arts before you call me, which is basically translating to me like, respect the hierarchy. But I'm like, I don't want to deal with the hierarchy. Like, what is it can I take to see a doctor without dealing with the hierarchy? And so basically it brings me to my next point, which is that I am fond of Germany because I find that Germany has taught me to be more direct. It's a place where people truly speak their mind, where rules are rules and laws are laws. And people, they are, in many cases, they have no nonsense mentality. But where is this directness when it comes to bureaucracy? Where is the directness when it comes to bureaucracy in a society in which we live, when it comes to health issues? Where is the directness? How is it that we live in this country, basically, where it's accepted to go up and down and around the corner and all around? Like, how is it any way productive and optimal for me as a patient who is in excruciating pain? How is it possible that someone has to go through 2 or 3 doctors to see the right doctor? You have a history in a clinic, but you can't go and see that doctor for issues that are related to the issue that you have. You need to go back to your house arts first, see them, have them clear it up, and then you go report to the second doctor. That is really interesting to me. What do you guys think about that? Have you guys experienced that? Foreigners in Germany, Germans in Germany, what do you guys think about that? Do you guys have similar stories? Again, it could be cultural, and this is also probably because Germany's health insurance is really good, and you know, everybody is insured, everybody has really good health insurance, so I do think that the wait lines are long, are typically long, but at the same time, I'm like, this is ridiculous at this point. Like, I can't even walk. I couldn't even walk. I had to take taxis. Like, there was money spent on taxis, me going around the city to see a doctor just to tell me that they couldn't solve the issue, to send me to another place. That was just mind-boggling to me. So yeah, those are my two cents on that's just a story that I wanted to share with you guys, that I made my doctor upset recently, but it really made me sit and think about how I live in a country that is very direct and plays by the rules. But then when it comes to bureaucracy, what are ways in which that maybe we could be more effective in Germany so that people who have more serious health conditions can get the help they need when they need it and not have to be lost in bureaucracy? Let me know what you guys think about that. Comment, like, subscribe, share this video if you care, and I'll see you next time. Ciao.